Now turning to a big showdown in the Big Apple, city workers, including law enforcement in New York City, have until tomorrow to get the COVID-19 vaccine or be placed on unpaid leave. Joining us now to discuss, New York Assemblyman Colin Schmidt. Good to see you, Assemblyman. Thanks so much for coming on here. I want to just get this out. The NYPD Commissioner Dermot Shea is pleading for the force to get the jab ahead of tomorrow's deadline, saying this: on Monday, when this thing starts being enforced, and if you're not vaccinated, no pay, and you won't be able to work. I don't think anyone wants that to happen. We need you out there. Please take advantage of the next few days. Get vaccinated. This comes as the NYPD is reporting just over 73% of police workers are vaccinated, which means almost a third are not. This, how big of a deal is this at this time to pull cops off the streets?
This is madness. We're seeing a crime spike across New York City. We are going into fire season in New York City as well, a heavy fire time, emergency service response time. And we're going into the holiday season where there's increased sanitation pickup. It is really a disservice and disgrace to our unionized public workers who are our first responders and frontline workers to put a mandate in really just a week and a half ago that has to be complied by 5 p.m. tomorrow. It's the definition of madness.
And just recently, a judge refused to block the vaccine mandate. They were looking to put a injunction essentially in place by the PBA, the Police Benevolent Association. They were not successful in doing that, but they will push forward in this legal battle. How do you see this playing out across the city? Do you see this staying in place, this mandate?
We are really facing a real safety and security crisis. The FDNY is planning for up to 20% of their firehouses and their not to be able to respond, to not to be adequately staffed come the beginning of the week. We are talking, as the numbers you said, with the NYPD and reduced patrols. The FDNY is ordering even vaccinated first responders to have their vacations and days off canceled. So now you have folks who are vaccinated and unvaccinated getting punished. And I'll point back, there was no problem just a few days ago. There was a vaccinate or a testing option. It was working fine. There were no issues at all. People were working throughout this pandemic, particularly the NYPD and FDNY, and there were no problems. So to change this last minute, to really go anti-union, and this is what you have in New York. You have New York City, total Democratic one-party control. Our state capital in Albany, total Democratic one-party control. And Washington, D.C., total Democratic one-party control. So there is no opposition voice for anyone who lives or works in New York City or the New York metropolitan area to push back on these issues. And these are our blue-collar heroes, our workers, our union members. And I have not heard from a single Democratic elected official willing to stand against Bill de Blasio or Governor Hochul and stand with our hero blue-collar union workers. The Democratic Party, is there not one member of the state legislature, one member of Democrat member of Congress willing to stand with me and stand with our union members in the FDNY, NYPD, and sanitation and say, we are standing for their rights as public first responder heroes to make their medical decisions that are in best interest for them and their families.
And just to be clear, for that, the restraining order to be put in place for the mandate, that may have failed. Court proceedings continue. They're going to have to present their case. So it's not out of legalities just yet. New York City firefighters also going to Mayor Bill de Blasio's home to protest the mandates. That's going to happen as well. Again, as you pointed out, Assemblyman, and rightfully so, these first responders were the ones that had to work through the pandemic. These are the ones we depended on. These are the ones at 7 p.m. we cheered for locally in the city there. So we'll see what happens with that. Assemblyman Colin Schmidt joining us live from New York. Assemblyman, thank you. Appreciate your time.
Thank you.